أشهد أن محمد رسول الله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على خير خلق الله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على نهجه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، Inshallah, we will start with after the praise, after we send our blessings, and after we give our thanks and blessings to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our blessings upon our Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I would like to inform you that tonight we will start our halaqa in a new book, and that is going to be about al-aqidah, tawheed. As we all know, يعني that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قضى تقريبا 13 سنة في مكة يدعو إلى ماذا؟ إلى التوحيد، لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله، توحيد. قضى حوالي 13 سنة في مكة يدعو إلى هذا. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spent 13 years calling the people of Mecca nothing but to accept the fifth, that there's no deity worth to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger of Allah. Nuh alayhi salam, he spent 1000 illa 50 aam, 1000 year except 50 years, so 50 years calling his people to la ilaha illallah, that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this book is about aqidah, what we as a Muslim we should believe in, what is our doctrines, what is our believing system. And the author of this book said Kitab al-Tawheed, the book of monotheisms, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال أول حاجة ذكر الآية قال ذكر قوله سبحانه وتعالى وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Anything that we see on the face of the earth, even if it is artificials, something that we as a human being create or design, there is a rationale, there is a hikmah, wisdom behind the creations of that. The car, the computers, all these things that we use today, there is a wisdom behind it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, and I created not the jinns and man except that they should worship me alone. So هذه حكمة من خلق الإنسان والجن. There is the wisdom behind the creations of the jinn and the mankind, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, we should worship none but one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah created us that we worship him alone, we should not associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what we learn from this ayah, what we get away from this ayah is many, but one thing that we know is that wujub ifrad Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bil ibadah, we have to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, we should not associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Idha sallayna nusalli liman lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we give zakat, we are giving zakat seeking the pleasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we go to hajj, إِذَا مَشَيْنَا لِلْحَجْ لِقَأَدَاءِ الْحَجْ, we are going to hajj for what? Seeking the blessings and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we give, we are giving for Allah. If we recite the Quran, we are doing it seeking the ajab from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is should be our نية. That it should be our goal, that we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and we should not associate anything with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, this ayah relate to us that Allah هو الخالق وما خلقته. يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala في هذه الآية دليل على أن الله هو الخالق والخالق هو المستحق للعبادة. Allah is the one who created us, so because he is the one that created us, the jinn, the mankind, so no one deserves to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And then the Mu'allif said, he mentions another verse that will emphasize the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذكر قوله سبحانه وتعالى ولقد بعثنا في كل أمة رسولا أن اعبدوا الله واجتنبوا الطاغوت. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the whole Quran that and verily we sent among every ummah, every community, nations, a messenger proclaiming worship Allah alone and avoid or keep away from طاغوت, which means false deities. والطاغوت مشتق من طغيان وهو مجاوزة الحد. وكل من عبد من غير من دون الله, كل ما عبد من دون الله وهو راض بالعبادة فهو طاغوت. Anything that is being worshipped and that person agreed that people should worship him, he becomes طاغوت والعياذ بالله. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى الحكمة من ابتعاث الرسل وإنزال الكتب هو الدعوة إلى توحيد الله سبحانه وتعالى, that we should worship Allah alone. That is the goal of sending all the messengers, all the Anbiya, the books that were revealed, all were revealed because that people should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ اِعْبُدُ اللَّهِ وَاجْتَنِبُ الطَّاغُوتِ, that we should worship Allah alone and we should not associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا إله إلا الله, we believe in Allah and that there's no deity worth it to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another verse, the Mu'allif mentions, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the whole Quran, and your Lord has decreed that you worship none but him alone and that you should be dutiful, grateful, kind to your parents. So, في هذه الآية, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يبين لنا وجوب توحيد الله سبحانه وتعالى. Allah enjoined upon us, declared that we should worship him alone and we should not associate any partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also we believe in this ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enjoined upon us that we should be dutiful to our parents. لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى في هذه الآية عطف حق الوالدين على حقه, فهذا دليل على عظم حقهما. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ. Allah has decreed upon you that you should worship none but Allah alone and وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا, and also be kind, dutiful to your parents. We learn that the centerpiece of our creations, our religions, our faith is a tawheed, to believe in the monotheisms, to believe that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Mu'allif also mentions another verse in the Holy Quran. He says, وَقَالَ تَعَالَى وَاعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do not associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if we recite all these ayat, it becomes clear to us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala serious about what? Tawheed. Serious about Tawheed. We should not associate partner with Allah in anything. And then another ayah that the Mu'allif mentions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ تَعَالَوْا أُطْلُ مَا حَرَّمَ عَلَيْكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ أَلَّا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, call the people of Mecca, call the people and narrate to them, recite to them things that Allah has made forbidden upon them, that they should not associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This ayah emphasizes that if we worship, we should worship Allah alone. We should worship Allah alone and that we should not associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This ayah, ayatul nisa al-an'am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions al-wasaya al-ashr, all the 9 commandments that Allah mentions, the 10 covenant that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, among which is that we should not associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should not kill innocent soul. We should be kind to our parents. We should also be kind to our parents. We should be just. We should call for justice. So all these things that Allah mentions, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam emphasized upon it, that there is the wasaya al-ash, that we should all keep fast 2. And then finally Hadith Muaz bin Jabal. Muaz bin Jabal, he was riding with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, Ya Muaz, atadri ma haqqu Allahi ala al-ibad wa haqqu al-ibad ala Allah? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Muaz, that, oh Muaz, do you know the rights that Allah has upon his servants? What are the rights of Allah upon his servants? And what are the rights of the servants upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is asking who? His companion? Mu'adh. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is asking his companions, Mu'adh bin Jabal. And then Mu'adh told Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that Allah wa rasuluhu a'lam. Allah and his messengers knows best. Allah and his messenger know best. يعني تأدبا منه للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. الآن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هو يعرف ولكن يريد أن يعلم معاذ عن طريق السؤال والإجابة والجواب. And then معاذ said Allah knows best. And then النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said that حق الله على العباد, that the rights of Allah upon every one of us, أن يعبدوه ولا يشركوا به شيئا. That we should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we should not associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he said to Mu'adh that وَحَقُّ الْعِبَادِ عَلَى اللَّهِ. And then the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon the rights of the servants, the khalaiq, upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that he should not punished with hellfire anyone who do not associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَّا يُعَذِّبَ مَنْ لَا يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ شَيْئًا. That he should not worship anyone, he should not punish anyone that do not associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this hadith, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained to us, illustrate to us, what are the rights of Allah upon us. That we should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. We should not associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we do that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless us and forgive us and admit us to Jannah, and he will not punish us with the hellfire. تَفَضُّلًا مِنَ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَرَحْمَهُ. Allah will do that in terms of his mercy and his blessings for us. So this is Kitab al-Tawheed. We as a Muslims, هذه عقيدتنا. أننا نعبد الله وحده ولا نشرك به شيئا. That we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and we do not associate a partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من الموحدين. هذا وصلي اللهم على نبينا محمد.